Hello guys, welcome back to the very, very long awaited new episode of Urban Design on City Skylines with the Priest. We're back in Verrucchio and, well, first of all, apologies. It's been way too long to get back into the YouTube arena, I guess we could say. I've been very busy and I really do apologize. I have been really wanting to upload new episodes to YouTube with development of the city. However, just due to time restraints, I have not had the time. You'll see with this episode, I'll be doing a bit of an overview of what's been done because there has been a lot of work done. Now, I've always been able to squeeze in 10, 20, sometimes an hour worth of gameplay here and there. Just messing around, trying to fix things, especially with a lot of new patches, or not patches, but releases and little minor updates being provided. That has caused a few issues here and there, so I've had to go in and just make things work. And I don't want to provide you guys with episodes of, you know, me spending 30 minutes trying to solve issues with traffic or why certain things aren't working. And especially with the new temperature thing that was introduced with the winter update, it's been causing a few financial issues for me with this city. The way that the temperature goes up and down and having to invest into heating, and I've changed the way that I've played the game a bit, where I've turned off hard mode. Well, it's still enabled, but I've turned on unlimited money while I readjust the city, and I can get balanced it. I can balance the budget out. You'll see that sometimes it goes up and down from positive to negative. But all in all, we'll get straight into it. So first of all, you'll realize that the skyline has changed quite drastically with the new update that came out not long ago. I can't even remember when, but we got introduced to Quays. So in this city, I've been working on changing that up from what I was using as temporary Quays to now having actual Quays. So it's working out really well, and there's a few new areas that I'd like to explain. But first of all, it's the downtown that I want to get into, because downtown is the one that's had the most amount of work or drastic change. So downtown has had a complete makeover. As you can see, that looks nothing what it used to be like. There are a couple of assets that are still there, like what they used to be, and that is the rail and the main highway still go underneath. However, I'll get straight into explaining what I've done, and that is I've cleared out the entire island and started from scratch pretty much. Now over here, this was my starting point. So as you can see, we used to have the highway over here, which now you can see runs underground, or in a sunken highway, but that used to be underground in a tunnel. So that's completely changed. Now it's in a sunken highway using the new quays, and it actually I've decided to mess around with this, and it's taken me quite a lot of time. This took me many hours here and there cumulatively, just setting it up, because what I've got is the train station, the main central station, which is the one that I was planning on. I can't remember from the last episode if I actually had implemented this or still the elevated one. But anyway, and nonetheless, this is what the new station was always supposed to be like, with the central station, because it incorporates the metro as well as the buses, and it's just an awesome looking building. So yeah, what I've got is the station actually is slapped right on top of the highway, and then what I've got is these railway lines from the station going on top of the highway, as you can see, and that just keeps going across. Ooh. And we've got these bridges coming across over here, and then on either side we've got slightly elevated terrain and a bit of residential buildings, small residential areas around here, so that works out quite nicely. So all we have is the highway actually jumps into a tunnel over here, and then the railway is also go into tunnels, and that kind of loops itself around. So that stacking system makes it really quite, space efficient, I guess. Don't have to have dedicated areas just for trains and just for the highway. But where that actual highway ends up going is it kind of curls or curves around over here underneath the ground and ends up over here. So this is what it would normally look like without those train tracks running over the top. So yeah, this is where we've done a bit of redevelopment as well on the university section. So you remember there used to be a bit of a park, tennis court and all that. Now it's slightly different. There's no more parks around here. It's more university complex with a major like art gallery, I believe, or something like that, or modern contemporary arts or whatever it may be. So that building, I thought, suits quite well with this area. As you can see, there's quite a lot of cars parked around here. Lots of you, the universities are definitely being utilized, so that's a good to see. But it's not completed around here because I haven't started yet completing this area in terms of filling it out with residential buildings, so that's still to come. What else have we done? We've been changing this whole area out. This used to all be residential, now it's a lot of offices. So offices that are still going to be being upgraded because they're only like level 1 or 2. So still a lot of progress ahead over here. Now you'll see, going back to where we were over here with these train tracks and this train and the highway, we've got this elevated ground. And then what I've done is slightly that similar to what Yuto did, was he was experimenting with levels. So that's something that I've done within the central island, where I'm experimenting with levels. And so all these residential kind of areas are located on a slightly higher level compared to the main island. And then this massive blank space over here, well, before it was massively blank, but now what I've done is entered this expo center and the Grand Mall. But the rest of this space is all going to be one massively large central park. So that's something I'm looking forward to working on. Still haven't thought of the design. We do, unfortunately, have a few things overlapping, but I thought when I looked at Central Park in New York, there's definitely like footpaths and roads that still cut through it. So that's what I'm kind of doing over here as well. Now, I did move the MCG Stadium from the other island onto the main island because of its location. It was causing some terrain effects, undesired terrain effects, which were leaking over into the actual canals. So every time I loaded it in, it would cause flooding. So I've removed it and moved it into the central island where there's no water surrounding it anywhere near. And it'll kind of join in really well with the park because I'm going to add potentially like some little sports facilities around here as well. So that's the idea of that. Now, also moving on to this next island over here, you'll see that this has quite dramatically changed. It used to be, if I just zoom in, it used to be just this. Now, with the new quays, I started messing around and now we've got this whole new addition over here. And this is all high density, residential, a bit of commercial. So it's working out nicely. And we still haven't finished it off, but still work in progress. Now, over here, this is it. Some more areas where we previously had worked on, but kind of changed around. There's no more tunnel linking between this island and the mainland up on top over here. That's all now connected via this highway. So before I actually get into the highways, for those of you that are really in love with the whole highway section or part of this city, I'll get to that in a short second. With the highways, skip over this main interchange that we've got over here. This is where we've got another neighborhood with high density, and anything that sprawls any further up on top of this hill is all going to start to be low density. So we'll have that kind of nice picturesque view from up on top of the mountain over here with no tall buildings really in the way. So that's the idea of that. And we've kind of been expanding across over here along this highway. So, and joining into the area where Kiyonokami is. So, as you can see, this is going to be the hardest thing to explain right here. Okay, so from previous episode, we had Kiyonokami over here, and as you can see, there's quite a few changes. Kei no Kami, with this avenue leading straight across over here, coming down and leading across over here, this was the end of the Kei no Kami section, and there used to be a beach around over here. However, with that beach, there was a lot of water passing by really quickly, like a tide, and it would have been just completely really shocking to swim in, I guess. And in the middle of, well, what really isn't a beach looking type area, I decided to remove it and just expand it with a few more commercial and even office spaces. And what I've done is, with the quays, I actually extended the island out and created a bit of a, like a, I don't know, end of the island, sort of a little mountain hill with a little tower where, I don't know, maybe like some sort of restaurants or observation deck can be taken advantage of from up here, so onto the city and surrounding areas. So I think this looks kind of very good. That's kind of come through my job, where I visited Brisbane a few times, and they've got this mountain called Mount Cutha, and it's literally just on the outskirts, or still literally within the city boundaries itself, like this mountain with a beautiful view over the top of seeing the entire Brisbane. So I've decided to do something similar to that. Utilizing this area as well, I decided to make another connection into the downtown area just to eliminate some of the pressure from the highways, because we don't have yet a full public transport system up and running yet. I haven't filled this area out with trees yet, so that's still work in progress. Now, this bridge is pretty low, and it's got the pillars over here, so that's done intentionally so that no major ships can come through here. It kind of locks up this area just for like smaller boats when I'm going to start putting all these piers and fancy stuff around. And then what we've done over here is, as well, we've extended the land out from the highway, which we normally had over here, and just provide a bit more space for another neighborhood. And this avenue over here, which is coming from over here, this is actually going to end up going uphill somewhere in a little bit of a curvy path or something like that, and join up with the avenue that's up over here. So with that, moving up over here, or actually before we go there, I'm just going to stream back down over here. So what we have is also some extra work being done around here. Now, as you can see, we've got some extra islands, or an extra island over here and over here. Now, what we had was, from this interchange down over here, this highway used to actually keep going straight, turn left, and then just simply join up over here. Kind of bland, with just a major river running through from our actual dam. So I decided to be a little bit more creative, and what we've done is, instead of just turning left, we've turned right towards the river, jumped across the river, made some nice bridges which join up with this unnamed suburb over here yet, and that just bypasses Kei no Kami on the left hand side over here. So Kei no Kami is on our right hand side, and it just swerves along as well, again to the left, and then just bypasses another two bridges, using this main island as kind of its supporting central point. Okay, and then jumps across, and then it joins onto the areas around over here. So that's how that joins up, and that's how that was created. And I'm really proud of this. This took me several hours to do this whole thing, and I've persevere through many floods where my population dropped by like 50,000, and then it's had to regenerate. So you'll see during the series that I might be facing a few death waves, so don't take that really into too much consideration. Everything's under control. It's just that large tidal waves cause a big indent into the population in terms of loss, and so then that population came back in one big boom. So I'm kind of having a few death waves until it kind of sorts itself out. But I've got more than enough compensation with cemeteries and crematoriums in the city. Now, there's this island over here which I'm still yet undecided on. I definitely do want to add like a bit of a hill or something over here, add something quite natural instead of just making it to another area with just, you know, suburbs and housing. I was actually considering of whether or not utilizing this island for something that I was supposed to do in my Santa Cangelo series. Now in that Santa Cangelo series, I developed a embassy for Yuto. In the very last episode before that city kind of failed on me with the new patches and expansions. So what I've got an idea is to join up a Yuto Flux Trance embassy on this island, supported by like lots of natural stuff, especially since Yuto's recent series has been quite environmentally friendly focused. So I'm thinking that something on those lines will be quite great to have in here, as well as with the work that Flux Trance does with his gardens. So make some sort of central garden or something like that on this island. I think it'll be quite a great send-off and an addition for something that wasn't incorporated really at the end of the Santa Cangelo series, which really disappointed me. So that's what I'm definitely going to try and do. Unless someone can provide me with a better option, then I'll definitely consider it. Now, if I just zoom out, this area is pretty much unchanged. So we've got all our industries, all our residential areas around here. Some of these areas are absolutely stunning. I absolutely love this area where you've got this avenue, the fencing, and these railway lines. And then if you turn left over here, it just looks so natural, so organic with these rocks. I mean, they're not the prettiest things, but still, they do the job. And then you've got this like railway line passing along over here. So yeah, I think that looks absolutely sensational. Now I'm gonna scroll up. Okay, so where am I gonna go? Over here. So actually no, before I get here, I'm gonna just move along to the farming lands. So the farms, I was actually having quite a lot of issues with traffic. There was a lot of dependency on just this one railway cargo station, so, and it's still pretty heavy, but it goes ebbs and flows pretty much, so I'm not too concerned about this. I don't have any more concerns or issues with this. This is as bad as it gets pretty much, so that's nothing to really shout about or be worried about, so that's fine. The farmlands have pretty much been unchanged apart from adding a few extra cargo terminals here and there, so just to help and deal with a lot of the traffic, because it's surprisingly surprising how much actual cargo comes out of all these farmlands. So moving on over here across the river, this is where we've actually started expanding our farmlands. Excuse me. And I've left a few little areas over here blank, so this is something that I'm going to be working on later on in this episode. And that's working on these farmlands over here. Just kind of finish it all off, tie it all off with this little extra town that I've made. And then also around over here, finish this whole area off with farmlands. So I think that will pretty much cover all the farming that's required. Now up on top of this hill, as I was supposed to do with the Santa Cangelo series, city, I was supposed to have an airport up here, which never eventuated, but now I actually do. Now there's still a lot of work that needs to be done around over here. This is just my, I guess I could say, my domestic airport. Nothing really too large, fancy. It's just on top of the hill. I'm going to make a little bit of a runoff area here and finish it off, surrounding with trees and security fences and all that extra jazz. So that's still, you know, with time to come, I'll have that done. I finally, for the first time, got utilization of the road over the dam, so I'm really happy with that. As this joins up to like temporary guidelines of where future neighborhoods are going to be around over here. The good old area over here where we started off our city has pretty much not changed. We're still going to have to keep expanding these neighborhoods as we grow. Now we don't have much demand for residential at this stage, more for commercial and industrial, so that's what we're going to be focusing on this episode. Now St. Kilda is an absolute mess around here, so don't take this into consideration. This is going to be a whole new redevelopment work in progress. So yeah, because this, you can see how badly this was done. So I think that the skills have kind of improved since then quite drastically. Or I'd like to hopefully think so, that I have improved, so this will definitely be fixed. I guess that covers pretty much everything. I started working a little bit of an oil industry over here, but that's going to change a little bit, because there's also going to be quite a few modifications going around here, because I'm going to start seeing if I can create some sort of like a harbour for a lot of my industrial stuff. But I still want to incorporate a lot of this oil industry here whilst having the oil, or sort of the cargo harbour around over here. So we'll see that work out. Now over here, something that you'll realise is that I've got a massive block of land over here, which is just completely vacant. Now this is also an idea of just to incorporate another, just simply, very large park. So whether it'll have mountains or hills, we'll see. I think it will, just to make it quite different. Now, a lot of the tall, really tall skyscrapers have been removed. I think it was just starting to get a little bit ridiculous with the height, so I kind of kept some all of the skyscrapers that are kind of relatively medium size. The tallest being is this Trump Tower building right over here. Now, this Trump Tower has actually been renamed to the Priest Tower, so that's my tower. It has to be the tallest tower in the city. Overall, within the city, we've got no traffic issues that are of a major concern. Sometimes here and there we get little blips, but I'll explain how this network works. And literally like 2 weeks ago, not even, we got the expansion with the Euro Soccer Championships, so I've put my stadium in on this slightly elevated terrain over here, and it's a really cool thing. It actually hosts events, and I'm not sure about anyone else's thinking, but in regards to future possible events or expansions, it's something that I'm really hoping that Colossal Order and the guys down at City Skylines really take into consideration, because I think they've worked this system out really well, where this stadium actually has events and people show up to this event and then they go home. Very similar to like what SimCity actually did work, where people would actually go to places at particular times for particular things. Now, this is something that I'm hoping that, as it has been, I must say, seeing the way it works, quite successful, is something that Colossal Order actually works on trying to expand. Where not only special venues and things like this actually draw in crowds at certain times, but the rest of the city, all things like even residential buildings, commercial buildings, shopping malls, like they kind of incorporate that rush hour effect, or not even rush hour, because there is a mod called Rush Hour, but without the mod, Colossal Order have proved to us that they can create simulations to buildings. And now I hope that they can take that step a step further and really expand on how buildings can affect the way citizens of the city actually kind of integrate or work with, communicate with it. So hopefully without having or requiring mods, if you're using the day-night cycle, we can actually get like a day night. In the morning you go to work, at night you come home, that whole real life trend, and it'll be a whole nother dynamic added to the game where you actually have to deal with traffic at certain times. So kudos to Colossal Order. I really hope that they take that into consideration, that they've done a really great job with that, and hope that they can incorporate it into other things as well. Now I guess moving on and to the last thing, and that is the highways. So before I get to the massive interchange, I'll explain what's happening. So I'll cover off the main interchange. So over here, what we had is we always had this highway over here going towards Konokami, and then switching right, and then switching right, and then moving on to this massive interchange, which is right over here. So this is all working absolutely perfectly. There's no issues here whatsoever. It doesn't stack more than 3 levels high. So it's not reaching some ridiculous heights. Now, with this, there have been quite a lot of modifications. So not the initial main base of this whole infrastructure is here. However, there definitely has been quite a lot of expansion going on in regards to connecting this highway over here. So this has had a lot of work over here. And this now has got ramps which lead onto other ramps to the original construction which was over here of all this interchanging. Now it's too much to explain, but it's a way just absolutely too much to explain. But if you had a road guide, or not even a road guide, you really would need a GPS for this, I believe, or the road signage would absolutely have to be spot on because it would get very complicated. But it does the job. It's just working on, it's just working on based on my ramp filtering system, which I still need to provide of how or what methodology I use to explain, or how I actually consider when you making my highways how the ramp filtering system actually does work. So that's something that I'll have to definitely consider in the future to try and provide for you guys. But it all works out and it's awesome. It really does filter the traffic really well. Now over here with this new highway extension that I was mentioning over here, this also now has a little connection between Kerinokami and jumps over onto this highway over here. So it's like an additional artery into the actual city itself. So kind of joining up two highways. Now it doesn't connect up perfectly in terms of connecting all directions. This only connects to certain directions because otherwise it would be utilizing too many shortcuts and I wouldn't want to force all the traffic over here. Now, moving on to this central area right here, this is where we had a whole bunch of ramps. Now, I've removed all of them, and you can see that this is still disconnected because I'm still doing a bit of testing, seeing how traffic actually works with or without this ramp over here. And at the moment, it's working quite well, so I think I might just completely remove it. But there was a whole lot of ramps that connected traffic coming from that side and from this side. And it used to actually loop around and end up going on this highway over here. So, but no, what I've done is actually removed it. Now there's only one connecting ramp over here to help with deal with the traffic flow. And with that, this highway is now actually connected. It actually connects, continues through as a highway, goes uphill, and then ends up going into this sunken area. Okay, and then ends up coming around over here. So this is where this is kind of leading out to, and it's still not completed. Just the main connections are done because I wasn't getting enough usage out of this area, but now I am, thanks to removing the connections around over here. Now, in order to jump across this bridge, this area right over here is the area that has to be utilized. So it's kind of forcing traffic to go in this direction, even though it is a bit longer, but it eliminates a lot of traffic issues that I was and congestion that I was getting over there. So that's the theory behind that. Now, over here with these farmlands, something that I forgot to explain is that we've got this train terminal over here, so that's just helping here provide extra support for the farming industry. Now, initially what I had over here was this highway was just on the ground connecting from left to right over here, as you can see. Now, what I've done is actually tunneled it and put the train station and network and a whole sort of area on top of that highway. So it's kind of utilizing the space a lot better than what it was before. And on the other side, I've got a temporary cargo depot over here, which is absolutely horrible. So this is definitely something that I'm still going to work on, and it's probably not going to be the actual location where this is going to be placed. So, but just for now, just to alleviate some of the traffic issues that I was having in there, this is where this is for a reason right now. So, but we'll see what happens when we try and, you know, fix things and make things pretty. And I think that's about it. There has been a lot of work. I'll give you guys another run through because this is something that I'm really proud of, is this whole highway connection, especially this whole new addition. I did this literally today. How it just joins up and jumps over this little bridge over here. Now, I'm not going to add anything onto this little island over here. I really like how natural kind of it looks. Something because... And this island as well, or on the side over here, I was just considering of having nothing but residential areas, but when I considered it, it was just going to be more just complete blocks and all that. I thought it won't look that great as it does right now, so that's why I've done that, and it looks really good. It really breaks things up a little bit here and there, just having residents absolutely everywhere, and it makes it look a lot cleaner and greener. Now going back to this highway over here, this is something I'm really proud of. There's an unbelievable amount of stacking of highways and filtering systems running through here that it's just mind-bogglingly crazy. But it's working, so I'm very, very happy. So yeah, and one thing before we go any further... this island over here, this is where we've got this highway going on straight. Now moving across to this island over here where we've got our main residential area, this island only has a highway going in one direction because of spacing. There's not much space on this island in all honesty, and there's only one direction people really need to go, and that's into downtown. So that's why I've done that. Now this highway actually jumps across this bridge onto this island. Now there's an exit over here, it keeps going straight, there's an on-ramp here, there's an exit over here, and then after that there's a lot of on-ramps here, here, over here, and then there's an exit over here, and then it kind of loops around on itself and then drives back up. And I've got traffic issues here again. Why don't these guys take utilize this ramp? I don't know why. That's something I'm going to have to figure out as to why this is going on, because it's giving me a headache. But this is something cool. Over here, look at this. We have got three highway ramps. If two wasn't enough, we've got three. Middle one goes in one direction and left and right goes in the other. Crazier, but it looks fantastic. We got lots of traffic utilization, so I'm really happy with it. So the way I've done this is we originally had our highways jumping next to Rod Laver Arena over here, cutting across through this island, doing this little quick left and right and jumping across. However, with this new highway running through the city, I decided that I'm going to join this up to the main island and make it come out where we originally had our kind of little loopy loop over here and our highway exit ramp. So this is where that third highway ramp comes out to, or that third highway comes out to into the downtown area. So I'm getting much better utilization of this exit ramp and the actual highway as well. Now if needed, vehicles that are driving on this highway can actually jump onto the either highway, even though you can't really see it. Oh well, maybe you can now. But what I'll do is jump in, and if you see we're driving on this highway, if we take a right, and then we take which way? I can't remember even. Okay, so yeah, if we take a right onto the first ramp and then take another right onto the next ramp, we'll actually end up being into this little loopy circle over here. And then we jump onto this second ramp, onto this actual highway, which actually goes underneath, does the whole loop around, okay, with a perfect gradient, goes from 0 to 3 to 6 to 9 to 12 height, okay, and then continues on. So instead of being on the highway which is on the far right, you're on the highway on the far left going the same direction into the city, but then instead of jumping on the actual top tier, which goes down through downtown, you actually jump into this tunnel over here and exit up, and you exit through the actual area right over here, and that ends up you in downtown. Alternatively, There is also another way to get into downtown, and that's via here, taking this wonderful sunken highway. Now, under this area, there are ramps, okay, which turn right and then do a big left U-turn or left hook, 90 degree hook, which end up going then in this direction, underground, underground, underground. And then when we get to this elevated terrain around over here, as you can see with the quay, it actually makes a right turn and then keeps going straight underground, underground, and ends up coming out right over here. It's too many tall buildings, it's moving up and down. So that's where it actually ends up being, is right over here. Can I get in there? No. Okay, so, oh my god, it's too many tall buildings. Okay, so that's where it ends up, right over here. Now, also, I have added an extra tram line over the top, kind of like a sky rail sort of a thing, which ends up going back to the main central station. So this actual tram line is here to facilitate the transportation of people. As you can see, it goes up, squiggles its way around. Actually, it is here to facilitate the actual stadium. So there's going to be a lot less trams in the city, but more, longer lines. So serving more important areas. And then they turn around into this suburban area, go down this little embankment, I guess, do a little civil and end up in the central station where we get a lot of people. And this is still isn't for full utilization because not all the metro lines have been properly connected up yet. So as you can see already, we're getting quite good utilization. Now, with this central station, I added a lot of car parks at the front. As you can see, a lot of it is getting used. And not only that, but because there's so many car parks, I also added a shopping center. So kind of really all works hand in hand quite well, I think. Now, what else? Oh, yes. So there is also another highway connection, and that comes off from this normal area that we had over here. Now, this highway used to connect to the other highway, which was always underground. But no, this now connects to a different area. So that actually goes underground underneath, skips by all this area, and comes out around over here. Okay. And then into the downtown area. So you can see where the original sunken highway was over here, which I have unchanged. I'm not using the new quays. These are still the old quays or old sunken highway mods or whatever they were. So that's what that is over here. And yeah, as you can see, there's not much stress or pressure being put on this area. So that's great. Now to know where this area is, I'll just zoom out so you guys can kind of get a representation of where that is. Okay, in regards to everything. So that's where it is. Now, there are other off-ramps, okay? I'll show you right now, is that from that highway, which goes underneath the river, there is an actual off-ramp, and it ends up coming out right over here. So you can see there's a ramp, or there's a road which comes out of the tunnel. Underneath this road, that's an actual road that leads off from that highway, so that's where that ends up, as you can see right here. Got two vehicles coming out. Now, that's actually running in what is an elevated piece of terrain over here, and we've got this main avenue. So this was one of the hardest things that I had to do a lot of playing around, and there were quite a few streams where I was messing around, seeing how I can actually connect the Deloduck Bridge across into the downtown area. First, I was thinking of doing a big circly loop around over here and then jumping in, but that proved to be quite inefficient and, well, ugly looking, especially because of how tall the bridge is. There was going to be literally nothing being able to be placed underneath. So I kind of extended it. I tried a T-intersection over here, which didn't work initially over the top of the rail lines connecting to the avenue over here, but that was pushing a lot of stress and pressure on this and causing up massive congestion. So I removed it, did it the actual opposite, went away from the downtown and came out to around over here, surrounded by a nice little tree area. So, and I'm surprised in all honesty at how much usage there is going on with this bridge. I was really surprised. Because of the highway connectivity in this city, I wasn't expecting, I seriously thought that this bridge would end up being pretty much redundant. But no, it's it's getting utilized really, really well. And as soon as we start probably expanding another high density residential area around over here, it's just going to put even more pressure and hopefully utilization on this bridge to get people into the downtown area. So I'm looking forward to that. No, I got to think, because there's so much more that I need to explain, I think. Let's see. All in all, look, the city's coming along really well, and the major airport, the international airport, is still getting utilized really well, as long as with along with the second one. So I haven't had any issues where the other airport is kind of trimming the planes coming in from the international airport, or so I'd like to say. So I'm really happy with that. I thought that would kind of have an adverse effect, but no, I get planes over there, I get planes over here. It's absolutely sensational. I'm really, really liking that. Later on down the track, I'm definitely going to have to work on adding or modifying the shipping routes within this area, so that I can start adding all the cruise ships to come into this area. It's going to be quite awesome, I reckon. But that's, you know, with time, I guess. When that will actually happen, just got to give it some time. Now, in regards to what else, I think that's pretty much it. So I'm actually not going to do any work, guys, for this episode. This is just a quick update of what's been going on, how the city looks like right now. Hopefully you guys like what I've done during my time while off camera, playing around with this city here and there. There's still definitely a lot of work that has to be done. I'm really looking forward to kind of filling in this area surrounding all this lake, or this little area with water. Just have this all filled out with residential areas. It's going to be absolutely stunning, I reckon. And have a little mountain or mount with a few ambassadorial or embassy buildings up here for Yuto and Fluxtrans. That'll be absolutely awesome, I reckon. That's it, guys. Once again, just to sum up, sorry for taking so long off camera. You know, priorities in life always have to things in life always have to take some sort of priority, and at that, in this stage, my new work took that over from me having enough time to actually provide you guys with quite a lot of quality content, hopefully. But now I'm going to try, potentially with a bit more time on my hands coming up, actually provide you now with some actual content instead of being able to stream. So don't forget, guys, to like the Facebook page in the link as well. I usually post up some photos of where I am on my travels during work, taking photos of, you know, buildings and ideas that kind of inspire me to possibly add into the actual city itself, like I did over here with the whole idea from Brisbane of Mount Cutha, as well as a few other ideas. Now also remember to like the Twitch page. If I'm a little bit lazy or not enough time to record an episode and develop the video for YouTube, I'm usually jumping on Twitch just to do a quick stream. Now, I don't do actual recordings of that, those Twitch streams, because I usually play music, which is normally copyrighted, so it usually ends up being soundless. But when I do stream, you guys will be notified if you like that page, so you can follow me on that and get notified when I'm jumping on, so you can kind of follow live content going on. Alright, guys, so hopefully you enjoyed this video. Provides you a great overview of what's going on. Hopefully in the future, or even this week, I'll definitely provide you another episode, which will be an actual work in progress of this city episode. Okay, so hopefully you enjoyed it. Please remember, don't forget to subscribe if you want to see more content, which I'm sure there'll be some coming out very, very soon. So for now, guys, take care, and I'll see you all very, very soon with new episodes. Bye-bye for now.